Nuclear waste simply tossed into the water. This was the face of waste disposal for decades. Greenpeace activists tried to prevent this, in vain. We also discovered pipes through which the nuclear waste is pumped into the sea.
Is there a scientific, logical reason why barrels are prohibited and discharges are allowed?
I think it is more a philosophical question.
We want to find out from the UK health authorities, can it really be true?
To reduce the doses any further might cost disproportionate amount of money that could be actually spent elsewhere. So that's the sort of balancing you have to do.
Is that supposed to mean that you are prepared to accept a number of cancer deaths to keep the costs of discharging atomic waste into the sea as low as possible?
You are doing that comparison.
I'm reading that.
And that's no different to what happens in many other areas of decision making in society.
Clark cites Epicurus's utility ethic.
Some examples: the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few, right? Everybody.
The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few.
Was a good thing. So you vaccinated everybody. The immunization.
Insiders tell us that the ICRP is the elongated arm of the nuclear industry. We also come across Professor Wakeford's name on the website, the expert from the University of Manchester. To our surprise, we also find Dr. John Cooper's name from Health Protection Agency.
You are working for the Health Protection Agency.
Yes.
At the same time, you are in the main body of the ICRP.
Yes.
So you give yourself the independent scientific
yes.
risk from one hand to the other. So
yeah.
in Germany, it would be a conflict of
interest. Yeah, yeah, a conflict of interest. Yes, that is a problem.
We're all in it together, kid.